Good morning, children. So today we are going to discuss the poem My Mother at 66. You know that from poetry there will be two questions. One will be a stanza followed by four questions of carrying four marks, and one question will be of two marks, short answer type question. So this is a very beautiful poem written by Kamala Das. First of all, I want to give you a brief introduction about Kamala Das. Kamala Das has been an Indian writer in English. She has written novels, short stories and poems under the name Madhavi Kutty. So the main theme of her writings is the human relationships. So in this poem, she tells us about her mother. The mother is aging and she is old and weak. So let's read the poem first. So look at the poem. It is written in a single sentence. So the thought process goes like this. Driving from my parents' home to Cochin last Friday morning, I saw my mother beside me, dozed, open-mouthed, her face ashen like that of a corpse, and realized with pain that she was as old as she looked, but soon put that thought away and looked out at young trees sprinting, the merry children spilling out of their homes. But after the airport's security check, standing a few yards away, I looked again at her van, pale as a late winter's moon, and felt that old familiar ache, my childhood's fear. But all I said was, "See you soon, Amma." All I did was smile and smile and smile. So, dear students, this is the poem. Now, let's look at the brief explanation of the poem. So, if we look at the first lines, driving from my parents' home to Cochin last Friday. So it means the poet is in a vehicle. We can say she is in a car and she is going to Cochin. Cochin is a city in Kerala, and it was Friday morning. When she was driving, her mother was beside her in the car. She saw her mother. Now look at the condition of the mother. The mother was dozed, open-mouthed, her face ashen like that of a corpse. Now the face of the mother has been compared to that of the face of a corpse. And the poet realized with pain that she was as old as looked, means the mother was extremely old. And the poet, she was sad, she was filled with pain, she was in sorrow. But to put that thought away, she looked out of the window of the car, and when she looked out, she found the young trees sprinting. Sprinting means moving fast. The young trees were moving fast, means they were moving backward. And she also looked the children, merry children. Merry children means the children full of enthusiasm, they were energetic. Spilling out means they were coming out of their homes. But after the airport's security checkup, but when she reached the airport and she was at the security checkup, she was standing a few yards away from her mother. She looked at the mother again. Now the mother has been compared to the late winter's moon, and she was wan, pale. So why the mother has been compared to the late winter's moon? We know that in winter season there is mist and fog. The moon is not very bright. It is dull. It does not shine lustrously. So the same is with the mother. She is old. She is weak. Her face is like that of a corpse. And the poet felt that old familiar ache. And she felt the old pain. And what is the pain? The pain is the fear of the separation from the mother. You know, the children, when they are separated from their parents, very young children, they have an unknown fear in their minds. So the poet feels that pain, the pain of separation from the mother. And again, to assure her mother, she said, she looked at the mother and she spoke the words Amma, and assured her by speaking the words, by giving a smile. So you look at the words smile and smile and smile. What does these words signify? They give the importance to the assurance that the poet gives to her mother. The assurance that soon they will meet again. They will be together. Although the poet has a fear in her mind, she is fearful that she might not be able to find her mother alive when she would return back. Now children, look at the meanings of the words. So if we look at the words, so these are beside. Beside means alongside or near. Then there is the word doze. Doze means nap or a short light sleep, especially during the day. Then if we look at the word ashen. Ashen means like ash, pale due to weakness and old age. Then look at the word corpse. Corpse means dead body, dead body of a human being. Then look at the word spilling. Spilling means let out or come out. Then there is the word sprinting. Sprinting means moving fast or running fast. Then there is the word wan. Wan means dim or weak. We also have heard about the waxing and waning of the moon. Then there is the word pale. Pale means dull, colorless. So these are some words from this poem. Now look at the poetic devices which have been applied in this poem. So children, if we look at the face of the mother, it has been compared first with that of a corpse. If we look at the words, her face, look at these words, it is her face ashen like that of a corpse. So this is